Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the nesting doll. Remember that Russian doll where it's a small doll inside another larger doll? And it's a whole series of dolls inside each other. This is the technical name. I won't even try to pronounce it. It looks Russian. So that's the process. But really think about what we have with our situations in music. We have a speaker inside a room and the room is inside a house. So we have that kind of nesting doll impact. Now, the nesting doll obviously is not concerned with audio, but we are definitely concerned with audio. And that's, you know, speaker energy source, room distortion source. That's really what you have. So you have speaker inside a room producing a whole series of distortions, pressure and reflections. And then the room is inside of a house, which produces a lot of issues also. One of the hardest things to do is lower the noise floor in a room. It's expensive. And especially if that room's inside a house, because houses generate lots of noise just on their own. So it's this layering and layering and layering of noise. And you're starting out with a speaker, which is the weakest part of the whole audio reproduction chain to begin with. You're putting it in a room that's doesn't like pressure or reflections. And then that room is in a house that's generating its own set of noise variables. So it's a cumulative effect. Most small rooms cannot handle energy below 300 hertz. So speaker's going to produce full range energy, and the room's not going to like half of it, approximately. So you're really fighting, you know, the numbers here in an uphill battle when you're using this kind of situation. It's the Schroder frequency, which is the breakpoint between wave and ray energy in your room. You can look that up. So that's what we need to look at. You know, room inside a house adds more distortion. Modal issues in small rooms, always less than 300 hertz. That's why we focus on that range for our product design, our ACDA series, and all of those. So you get an idea of how that all works. Treatment, frequency, and amplitude. Got to have the proper rate of absorption. That's very, very, very critical. And if you don't get enough of the right type and you don't get enough amount, and you don't put it in the right place, you're not going to get the results you do. So the type has to have rate and level, square footage, and it's got to be in all three sound fields. Remember, our sound fields are floor to ceiling, sidewall to sidewall, and then we got front to rear, right? In our rooms. So you got three sound fields that you have to treat. Diffusion requirements. You got to do your homework with absorption first before you can bring in diffusion. Diffusion's like extra credit in school. So I hope this kind of gives you an idea of what you're fighting in terms of noise floor, in terms of room modal pressure and reflections, and all of those issues also. The nesting doll. I hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.